This is the hardest, most complex telescope humanity has ever built.
1 million miles from Earth.
We tested and we tested and we tested. We have to get it right. We can't go fix it.
Peering deeper into the cosmos than ever before.
It's a telescope that can see back to the Big Bang.
What will the first images?
NASA's James Webb telescope is providing scientists with images of space like never before, including this image, the deepest photo ever taken of the universe.
This telescope is considered to be the most powerful instrument ever launched into space, but it took years for it to be developed. The new PBS docuseries Ultimate Space Telescope explores the history and the making behind the telescope. And joining us to discuss more is producer Terry Randall and Webb Mission Systems engineer Mike Menzel. Good morning. Thank you for joining us this morning.
Good morning.
Thank you.
So we look at those pictures that everybody saw from the Webb telescope, and I think most people say, wow, that's pretty cool, but don't know what else to make of it. What do you make of it? What are we looking at? What are we trying to figure out there?
Well, James Webb was designed to see the very first galaxies and stars that turned on in the universe after the Big Bang. We don't know exactly when these stars turned on, but it turns, you know, we believe they turned on within a 100 to 200 to 300 million years after the Big Bang. So we're trying to see those very faint objects. And the photos that we've taken so far, the images that we've taken, indicate that we will very much be able to see them.
And for those who don't know, I mean, I'm a novice when it comes to space. I can't really tell what's amazing or not because I don't have an eye for it. For the average person, this telescope compared to the Hubble telescope that we remember, talk about how much stronger it is.
Well, the photo is the best way to say that. The deep field that Hubble took somewhere between 10 and 14 days of exposure. Our telescope went deeper than Hubble within 2 hours.
Wow.
And we haven't even cranked it up yet. We're gonna go to a 7-day exposure. So we have about 6 times the collecting area of Hubble, and we are about 100 times as sensitive. 100 times more sensitive.
And I guess the ultimate question relates to the Big Bang and life and whether there's livable planets out there. Are we getting closer to those answers?
The answer is yes. A telescope like James Webb will be capable of doing spectroscopy, that looking at the colors of these exoplanets and looking to see if we see colors of biomarkers. Compounds or elements that are either produced by life or necessary for life. And we know of about 4,000 to 5,000 planets around other stars right now. So James Webb will be looking, doing spectroscopy, chemical analysis of those exoplanets.
So Terry, aside from the great pictures, I'm assuming the story behind getting this telescope made is what kind of makes it a documentary.
It was a long process, which, as Mike knows, took decades, developing innovative technology that's never been flown in space before. And watching the team get the telescope up in space, deploy the telescope, which was extremely complicated and innovative again, was really an interesting and amazing experience to see what they were doing, how they did it, and how they did it so beautifully.
Wow.
Well, you can watch Ultimate Space Telescope now at pbs.org/Nova. You can also find it on YouTube at Nova PBS Official. Terry and Mike, thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Thank you.